we go to the electrifications, is what I touched just now. So for this topic, the division topic two of the train design. So in this design, for train, we have three type. Actually, we have more, but for Xayaburi, we only provide three type of electrifications, train electrifications, which is busbar, PVC conductor, which is called conductor string into the PVC enclosed, then festoon system, tapering system. So let's go to train electrifications system. So for busbar, in busbar system, we actually divided into single line and multi line busbar system. How we differentiate single line and multi line? So when maintenance team wants to replace the busbar line, the electrification for the crane, we all have to look at what type of busbar we are providing to the crane, what type. So how to differentiate this is from the enclosure or from the outlook. So here actually we summarize in brief. We have a detailed notes on this. Maybe in the future, if anyone wants to know more, we can share the detailed slide. But this is just a summary of busbar system for what we have delivered to Xayaburi. Here we have a multi-line busbar system. About multi-line busbar system where they have in an enclosure, they have more than one copper strip. This is the copper strip used for conducting the power supply for the train, right? And yeah, for this case, you can see this is a four busbar. It doesn't stop here for busbar. For the busbar, actually, when it goes multi-pole, it can go for 6-pole, 8-pole, or any 12-poles. But for us supplying to VME, to Xayaburi project, we provide 4-pole. Why? This is the phases for the train. For Malaysia is red, yellow, blue, but in Laos is red, white, black. Red, white, black. And this is the ground. So grounding means the earth. We have a marking on the busbar line. There's marking over here. If you can see, there's marking on the line, which means this is the line where we connect the ground in the busbar. So don't ever connect the live line to the ground line. You shock the whole thing. Because this is already indicated for grounding. So think on this. So sometimes people didn't aware, and you say, oh, this is 4-pole, any pole you can use, you can put this red here, black here, white here. Then a new people come in, they thought, okay, this is ground line. Then you tap here. So it's totally wrong. So this is what they indicate for grounding, specifically indicate for grounding for busbar. Here will be the summary components available in the busbar, where this is what we call the incoming cable. We go into a feeding point. This feeding point, when they say end feed, means the power supply going in, feeding from this end. So okay, I'll proceed first. So from end feed and line feed, actually the power supply feeding in from here, end feed and line feed is the supply where we tap the power in from cable. For us in Malaysia, we call it rising cable. For Laos, I'm not sure, but that will be the supply from your EV distribution board or from the isolator straight to these two points. Why they have two different feeding points, end feed and line feed? End feed because when the runway is short, we can use end feed. But if the runway exceeding 75 meters, we have to use line feed. The reason why we have to use line feed and end feed, because we want to reduce the voltage drop along the busbar line. So if we use line feed here, which means in between the distance, we can maintain the feed-in supply of the distance. I mean, feed-in voltage supply to the busbar. So that's why we use line feed over here. If it's the runway for the thing is for the busbar is more than 75 meters. For Xayaburi, mainly is the mid feed because the distance is very long. If the distance of the runway is short, we use end feed, right? Okay. So how we transmit the power to the crane? Because this busbar is power supply along the crane runway. How we transmit the supply back to the crane is actually via this current collector. The current collector will tap the supply to the busbar line and use the towing arm go up to the crane. So this is the cable from the current collector will go up to our main control panel of our crane. Okay, the rest is the point, is the components. You all can review later. So this is a sliding slide. They have fixed hanger. All this is the components inside the busbar system. So if there is anything damaged or spoiled, you can just refer to this photo, this slide. You can just contact any busbar supplier, telling them what have damaged. Either it's a joint tag or a hanger have spoiled or towing up. From here you know what's the name, the correct terms, the name for the busbar system, right? So basically this is the multi-line busbar system. So for bracket, maybe I touch a bit what's the difference between the support bracket. We have support bracket here. Support bracket, we have sliding hanger and fixed hanger. Why we use sliding hanger and why we call fixed hanger? So because in a busbar system, it was installed outdoor. So why we use sliding hanger? Because it allowed the busbar to slide a bit when there is an expansion of the busbar. Because it's placed outdoor, they're exposed to the temperature where it's cold and hot. So, because this is the characteristic of thermoplastic, the material for this is called thermoplastic for busbar. It's a PVC, but it's not. It's the more specific is called thermoplastic. So, when it's hot, it will expand. So, if we use a fixed hanger over here, it will just lock the thing, the busbar into a position. So, when it expands, the busbar will curve. And from far, you see it's like a wavy, snake-like busbar. Then you claim why we install the thing wrongly. But actually, if we put a wrong bracket to the busbar, you cause this. But if we put the sliding hanger to the correct position, the busbar will be expanding accordingly and allow a free space for the busbar. So next, we go to another busbar system as well, but this is called single line busbar. We use in phase one of the train. So why we use this? Why we use this and why we use this? So for higher capacity, advisable for us to use, we separate the supply to individual enclosure. So why? That's why for higher supply, higher end ampere, we use single line busbar. The component is the same. Joint box, support bracket, hanger, everything the same as well as current collector. The difference is this multi-line busbar system, every copper strip in an enclosure. But for single line, they have their separate own enclosure into the crane for the supply. So you see here, each phase have their own enclosure. And same goes to the line. We have a grounding. So nothing, basically it's the same. The difference is only the enclosure over here. So we go next, it's the fashion system. This one we apply at the fish grounder, we apply at this monorail. All this are actually flat cable or a round cable which use transmit supply and signal to the plane, right? So not to touch much, I just tell review. This is the if you face any problem with the pattern system, you need a replacement, you want to contact supplier of a pattern system, you can see what is the part, these components individual specific parts of pattern system, you can just contact them. Or okay, my track joint was missing, or my trolley was spoiled, bearing trolley or steel trolley or nylon trolley, so it's here. You can get the parts from here. The last electrification used in our plane was cable reel. Cable reel is very, very common. You can see in the plane industry, very common we use cable reel. So cable reel is where we actually transmit power using a big reel through a round cable, which can be a round cable to the isolator. This time maybe they will be isolated. So here you can see all the cable reel we supply for Xayaburi are authorized cable reel. But in the market, they have motorized as well as free cable reel. But for this job, we only supply motorized cable reel. So this is, you can see the motor over here in our reel system. And this is the rope guide. The reason why we have to make sure the cable going to the cable reel are in position, so it won't get tangled or off position and spoil the cable. So that's why we use cable rope guide. Sorry, it's not actually, but this is typo. It's not called rope guide. It's a cable roller guide. So this is a slight typo over here. Instead of a rope guide, it's actually called roller guide. So this rope is called roller guide. Sorry, this is my typo over here. It's called roller guide. Cable roller guide. So that's my typo. So this is basically all about electrifications. We have nothing to ask. I'll proceed to the next slide.